division. But right out of the gate, we have some junior lightweights. It's an 8-rounder featuring unbeaten Angel Luna. Comes to us from Santo Domingo, Dominican Republic. 70 amateur fights in all. And this is his fourth straight fight in the good old U.S. of A. His opponent from the fighting town of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Tevin Farmer, who believes he's getting better each and every fight. He has 11 brothers and sisters. He's right in the middle, sixth oldest, tough to get to the dinner table. No wonder he's fighting a junior lightweight. Todd Grisham and Teddy Atlas ringside, back in one of our favorite stomping zones, Mohegan Sun Resort and Casino, Teddy.
Always excited to be here, and a good crowd, which makes it even better when there's a little electricity in the air. Well, easy to call fights.
And this kicks off what will be, or at least should be, a great weekend. Some big fights coming your way, all the way from here in Connecticut, New York tomorrow night, over to Texas, then to California. We'll have a preview of some of those fights coming up. And I look back to what happened last week between Lamont Peterson and Danny Garcia. But first things first, as we get ready for Luna versus Farmer.
Trunks are good. Obey my commands at all times. Protect yourself at all times. Toco los guantes. Buena suerte. Touch him up. Good luck to you.
That's one of, Harvey Dock is one of the young and developing referees. You know, we talk about the fighters who are young and developing, maybe future stars. I think Harvey Dock might be one of those future stars as a ref.
You're still young and developing yourself, I must say.
And developed. Thank you.
Luna will be fighting from an orthodox stance. He'll be facing Farmer, who is a southpaw.
Well, I don't know how good Farmer can fight. We'll find out a little bit, but I know that he's got the great bloodlines. He claims that he's the great nephew, that one of the greatest fighters in the history of this sport, for me, one of the top 10 fighters in the history of boxing, is his great uncle. And that would be a fighter from the early 1900s, the great, and I'll say it again, the great Joe Gans. Joe Gans was a lightweight champion of the world.
First African-American world boxing champion, in fact. I doubt Gans had the same trunks that Farmer has chosen to wear tonight. The Bengal Tiger look, taking on Luna in the more traditional solid black.
Well, Farmer, southpaw, no matter what his trunks are, he's coming at you from the opposite place. And Farmer, from what all my people tell me and from the reports I got on him, he's a slickster. And he's starting to show that early. You know, he's a guy that likes defense, likes legs. It's going to be, the pressure is going to be on Luna to make the fight, to press the fight. And you know what? To take chances and maybe walk into punches, because Farmer is not going to take chances. That's not his DNA. It's the lay back, it's to set traps, to get angles, to keep you confused, keep you off balance a little bit. Again, Luna, he's got to be the seek and destroy guy here tonight.
Farmer, you mentioned, wouldn't be taking many chances, has only 4 knockout wins in his 18 victories, whereas Luna has 7 knockouts in his 11 professional victories.
Listen, simply put, Luna depends on pressure and physicality to win. Farmer on technique and intellect.
A nice that right kind of hook stuff there by Farmer.
Yeah, countering, you know, slickness. Finesse, that's Farmer. Only blemish on the record of Luna is a draw. And from people that were there I talked to, they thought he won the fight, so could easily be undefeated. Luna could, maybe if the judges did a better job in that fight that he got a draw. But he's not doing here, Luna. He's not using his jab to close the gap. And he's gonna lose the fight. It's very early, he's gonna lose the fight if he doesn't press behind the jab with a guy who has good eyes like Farmer. Because Farmer sees you coming and he picks you apart. You gotta throw a jab when you press.
And we are once again honored to have Nigel Collins with us here tonight. He's standing by with Bernardo Osuna.
Time! Todd and the fights that have taken place in the rich history of boxing. We're also going to talk a little bit about social media and the huge impact it had on the fight.
We send you down for round two.
Can't wait to hear more from Nigel coming up a little later on. A fast start to round two here between Farmer and Luna, Ted.
Well, again, if Luna's going to win, it's going to be with pressure getting in the chest of Farmer. Farmer's going to win, it's going to win with space and countering. And right now, this round, as you just alluded to, starts right for Luna, getting in the chest, getting close to Farmer. That's how he's going to win.
Stop.
Glove touch there. They need to wipe that glove off. And that's why I think he's a young, maybe future star referee. The referee knew that that glove touched. He made sure there's no foreign substance that could be on the glove, on the floor. He made sure he wiped it off so it doesn't get in the eye, obviously, of the opponent.
Stop.
And again, Farmer with more of a pushing blow to the side of Luna's head, sends him to the canvas. Gloves get wiped off again.
Again, if Luna is going to be effective, I know he's going to press. There's a difference between pressing and being effective when you press. Got to press behind that jab, put some bugs on the windshield, on the eyes of Farmer. So Farmer doesn't do that. See him coming in and counter. Farmer's really a slickster in there. Watch him. He's got good skills. Good technique. Makes you miss counters.
Keep up.
Luna, as you can see on his trunks, known as El Gato, the cat. And when you're watching at home, Teddy, I'm sure you're a fan. Maybe you don't know too much about these guys. You want to find a reason either to root for them or against them. Farmer says he wants to be a role model for all the kids in Philadelphia and all over the world, loves to give back. As for Luna, when he's not in the boxing gym, he likes to go to church. So who do you pull against in this fight?
Neither one. You pull for both of them. They're two fine, I mean fine, young men. And decent fighters, too. And again, the more refined fighter so far, and no surprise to me, because it really sits with the scouting reports I got on him. Farmer, the more refined guy, more developed.
Farmer played football and basketball in high school, and then one time he said he had a lull, didn't really have either sport to focus on. They were both out of season, so he went to the gym, trained in boxing just to stay in shape, fell in love, and never went back to the other sports.
You know, Luna's just throwing punches, but Farmer is placing punches. Big difference.
See on his trunks, Farmer, American Idol. That was a moniker given to him by some of his friends in Philadelphia because he is such a good role model to some of the disadvantaged youth there in Philadelphia. And he looks pretty darn good tonight as we approach the end of round two.
Punches from way back. And he moves his head. Finds a way to get inside. Harrison is younger, faster, sharper, but is he as good as he looks? See, that's it. That's the question that Munguia will look to get answered tonight. By the way, you are as good as you look, my friend.
I don't know if that's a compliment or not.
We got there. You know, it was a little dicey.
Right.
It was a little dicey there.
We made it.
We got there. Okay, you fans out there, didn't we? We got there. You thought there was going to be blood drawn from Todd. No, not at all. I love him.
Also, keep in mind, Munguia, either 7 or 8 inches shorter than Tony Harrison, depending on what height you believe, is listed at 5'7". But when we saw him yesterday, he looked closer to 5'4". Right now, Farmer and Luna, 5'5" and 5'6" respectively, engaged in a very entertaining chess match here. Round three of a scheduled 8 in the junior lightweight division.
See, this is where Luna wants to be.
Nice uppercut there from
Farmer.
Inside,
but that's not the result he wants, because he's a sharper guy. Luna can't win if he's not inside, so I don't blame him for being there. This is the only way that he's going to win. But Farmer's better on the outside. He's pretty good on the inside, because he makes you miss, and he makes you pay. Luna doesn't make you miss a lot.
I mentioned earlier that Farmer believes he's getting better with each and every fight. You look at his record, 18-4-1. You're not exactly blown away, but he thinks a couple more wins, and he'll be in perhaps title range. Another uppercut there from Farmer, who's starting to land some of those power punches.
Again, Farmer knows what he's doing. He has a good boxing IQ. He's been talking about a little shove there with his shoulder.
Push off, the young ref
that I think is going to be pretty good, he jumps right in there, gives him a warning.
That's Harvey Dock. Also scheduled to referee our co-main event today. That being Danny Aquino taking on Ryan Kilczewski. Kilczewski, known as the Polish Prince, 22-0.
Okay, Luna needs that jab if he's going to come forward on Farmer. Otherwise, that's going to happen. He's going to get shots thrown at him because there's nothing blocking his vision. Luna needs to block the vision of Farmer coming in.
Also, you don't see that too often. Players leaving early to go to the WNBA. We're on round four of a scheduled eight. Tevin Farmer, who's won 11 straight fights, taking on unbeaten Angel Luna out of the Dominican Republic. And so far, Farmer looks to be in good shape.
And a good fighter, besides being in good position.
Now Luna backing him up to the ropes. He has been keeping the pressure on, but it hasn't seemingly been effective pressure.
Speaking of pressure, speaking of condition, I'm going to guess, but it's an educated guess, calculated guess, that Farmer's in better condition than Luna when it comes down the stretch. Luna took this fight on about 5 days' notice, and he came in his heaviest weight in almost 3 years. So a lot of advantages right now for Farmer.
At the top of the program, I mentioned a couple of big fights we're having this weekend. We'll break down Provodnikov's big battle against Lucas Matisse a little later on. But Teddy, what are your quick thoughts on the return of Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. taking on Funfara, who we've seen here on Friday Night Fights?
You get what you get with Chavez. He's a tough guy. You know, he comes with a good body shot there by Luna. He's a tough guy. He will come forward. He will go to the body. He's not the hardest guy to find. He's in front of you. He'll make entertaining fights. You wonder if he's in condition. He's had problems with partying too much. The question is he in top shape? And as far as Funfara, if Funfara can land the right hand, he's got a chance. He's got to catch Chavez coming in with the right hand. He punches pretty good with the right hand. But other than that, it'll be Chavez chopping that tree, and trying to get a chance to yell timber around 9 or 10 rounds. It'll be Chavez, I think, winning a decision, or maybe he has a real good night, maybe a late round knockout, but a good entertaining bout.
And that's what we've got here between Farmer and Luna so far. Chavez has switched trainers, by the way, now with Joe Goosen. Freddie Roach pretty much gave up on Chavez after he gave up on himself by failing to train properly for his fight against Sergio Martinez.
He's got a little Johnny Manziel in him. Except he's accomplished things. Johnny Manziel hasn't accomplished anything.
In college,
yet.
He did.
In college, yes. In college, you're right. That's very true. We're talking about the four pay ranks. Hasn't done anything in those ranks. Farmer grabbing. No surprise to see him grabbing inside. Again, he's a slickster. He knows he belongs on the outside. He can handle himself inside. He'd rather be outside with space.
Coming up tonight in our main event, undefeated Tony Superbad Harrison in action. Bernardo Osuna speaking with the unbeaten fighter.
Hey.
Successful man is a strong woman, but I guess not in the case of Tony Harrison. He doesn't have time for women.
Seconds out.
Well, I'm not so sure I took that out of that.
I'm going by what he said. He said, I don't have time for women.
Well, at this moment.
Yeah. Well, he is single, no children. Said he just loves fighting right now. He's doing a pretty darn good job of it, but he'll have his work cut out for him tonight in our main event.
Again, Luna, doesn't press behind that jab. A lot of incoming coming at him. See, Farmer is so slick. He doesn't mind if he's inside, outside, even though he belongs outside. And he's a bigger guy, too. I mean, he's bigger. He's been between junior lightweight and lightweight most of his career, Todd. Well, Luna has only been a featherweight most of his career. Only 125 pounds his last two fights, Mr. Luna.
Luna in the face looks a lot like Yuri Gamboa. Of course, the Cuban boxer, who most recently lost to Terrence Crawford, at least most notably. Right now, Elgato trying to figure out Farmer, hasn't been able to seemingly do so, as Farmer has been very effective with the jab and with counter shots.
Farmer has, you know, those bloodlines to Joe Gans. Maybe they're showing a little bit, but he's got a good instinct in that ring. I don't want to say he's a natural, but he's pretty good for a guy who only had 16 amateur fights, I'll tell you that. And he's fighting a guy in Luna who had a lot more. He had about 70 amateur fights.
Maybe that's why Farmer got off to such a slow start. 4-4-1, and then went on an 11-fight win streak. Actually, I'm sorry, 7-4-1, 11-fight win streak. Either way, he's on a win streak, Ted.
Yeah, well, one of the reasons, actually, to piggyback off of what you started saying, that Luna has a slow start, I think here tonight, one of them, besides not using his jab. If you go back three fights, Luna was off almost 1.5 years.
Nice counter right there by Farmer, and follows it up with a straight right. Farmer picking Luna apart as these rounds go on.
Look, both guys are tough. If you're in that ring, there's a certain level of toughness. And Luna is showing that by trying to overcome a slicker fighter, better fighter, faster fighter. But like the old timers would always say to me, especially Customato, when you got two tough guys and one is smarter, he's much tougher. And right now that man is Farmer. He's smarter. He's slicker.
Quick!
Makes him tougher.
Nice left hand, and Luna goes off balance as we come to the end of the round.
Scene. I mean, just look at that record. 196 fights, lost only 10. 20 no decision fights, where in most of them he got the newspaper decision. In those days, it was a lot of areas, a lot of states that didn't allow boxing. I mean, this is a guy who, he's historic. I mean, you mentioned it. Joe Gans, the first African-American world champion. The first black world champion for the fans out there, the really good fans that could go back with history that way and are interested. The first black world champion was George Dixon in 1890. He was from Canada. He was a bantamweight and a featherweight champ. But Joe Gans, he's one of those rare breeds that matches up with any era. Special guy. 100 knockouts.
That's incredible, especially for that weight class.
I think it's incredible for any weight class.
Right!
I get what you're saying.
Well, Joe Gans would certainly be proud of what his great-great-nephew is doing in his career and with his life. Very charitable person. Said besides boxing, which is his only job, he loves philanthropy, loves meeting with high school age kids, helping them stay on the straight and narrow, keep them off the street. Wants to be a world champion, just to be a role model, an American idol, if you will, for Philadelphia.
See, again, the big advantage here, all those fans at home, I mean, for me, the big advantage is simple. It's about slickness. It's about making the guy miss. It's about the sweet science. Farmer makes you miss, and he creates openings. Luna doesn't really make you miss. He's got to force openings. A little harder to do. And you have to take more to force openings. It's easier to create openings by making someone miss. It's a cleaner fight for you. Farmer fights a clean fight. Look at those clean shots. again by that little step back, that little bit of science.
Watch your head. You can see with the step back too by Farmer caused Luna to fall forward almost off balance.
Because he felt that Luna was dependent on him for balance. So he, you know, he pulled the rug out from under him, and he did it again there. Both guys in there close with their heads. Surprised there's been no banging of heads yet. Look at that little move to the side. On the other side, science.
Be sure to check out our Friday Night Fights Facebook page. You can score this and every round. Compare your scores with Teddy Atlas, or you can go to fnfvote.com. Round 6 of 8 here from Mohegan Sun. Teddy, I was checking out Twitter. Matt in St. Pete said, hey, Teddy, I just feel like Luna fights with so much wasted movement, he looked burned out after only 5 rounds. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I mean, I think we've been kind of saying that, haven't we? That, you know,
keep that hand down.
Luna just throws punches where Farmer places punches. I remember saying that earlier, which is basically what that fan is talking about. You know, Farmer is more concise, more... He doesn't waste much. Luna is just chucking punches and trying to force stuff. Luna has to work a lot harder to get something done than Farmer, because one of the reasons is Farmer does that. He makes you miss, and then he's in position to throw something accurate. Luna gets hit, and that's a lot of, I mean, that's a lot of work, a lot of effort that you got to walk in, you got to take punches, and you got to force your way in. It takes a lot more to do that, and a lot more difficult to do that than if you make a guy miss, or if you're good enough to make a guy miss, and then make him pay. A lot less wear and tear, you know, during a fight on Farmer.
Teddy Atlas, as well as those of you watching at home, had this a clean sweep for Farmer over Luna, 6 rounds to none.
See, right now, Farmer's looking like the Southpaw version of Floyd Mayweather.
Oh, nice combination there. Slice him and dice him by Tevin Farmer. And another counter shot.
Put it down, put your hand down, keep it down.
Again, no jab as Luna presses in. Aggressive, but not effective.
For Farmer after this fight, he'll be back to the gym. He's a boxing professional only, has no other job, but Luna is a barber, has a barber shop in the Williamsburg section of Brooklyn. He started cutting hair in Santo Domingo, decided to keep it going when he came to the United States.
Well, this is not a close shave tonight.
Did I set you up for that one or what?
Yes, thank you.
Good team. Teamwork.
That's good. That was a beach play.
You could say, though, Farmer is head and shoulders better than Luna.
Well, you could just stop now. Oh, go ahead. And I think that'll do her. And I'm sure the people in the truck would appreciate that too.
Let him go. Stop holding.
Again, no jab from Luna. Good vision, good eyes by Farmer. He can do his work.
Desperation time for El Gato. Can Angel Luna come up with something big in round 8? Whoa!
Time!
Working your way up the ladder. That's exactly what Mr. Farmer's doing. Some downstairs and eventually 2 upstairs. Gets the job done. Setting it up nicely.
Catch him up.
If you're Luna's corner, what do you tell him right now as he has 3 minutes to figure something out?
Chuck a lot of right hands. Right hands land sometimes with a southpaw. Get lucky. Best punch to get lucky with against the lefty would be a right. See, I would have told him really from the beginning, give a little feint before you throw. Don't throw cold punches with a guy that has radar. You know, throw him off. Throw his radar off a little bit. Feint a little bit, and then chuck something. Get him to make a move.
They're both chucking right now.
Let's go.
Farmer sitting down on his punches. He wants the knockout here, just as bad as Luna does. 1, 2, 3 again from Farmer.
Yeah, Farmer's giving Luna a chance. Even if he gets the better of it, he's giving Luna the chance he needs by being in front of him and giving him a chance to land that big punch. If he does this, Farmer has less of a chance when he moves. Or Luna, I should say, has less of a chance when Farmer moves.
Farmer wanted to get noticed tonight on national television, and he's certainly getting our attention with this performance.
And getting a good review. Three other people to review him. He's getting a critically acclaimed review.
The Teddy Atlas stamp of approval, I'm sure, carries a lot of weight. They all look for it. They seek it. And he seems to be getting it from you tonight.
Yeah, he's gotten it. And even at the end, I don't blame him for standing there. But he was choosing the wrong geography at the end, about 40 seconds ago, by giving Luna the one shot he needed by standing in front of him. But he also was feeling like a fighter, feeling like a winner, and acting like one. And it is about entertainment. And if he's going to make it in this business, he's got to mix the entertainment with the slickness, with the effectiveness, with the skills.
And now Farmer measuring his shots here, pawing at Luna.
Farmer got away with a little foul earlier. He held Luna behind the head, kind of positioned his head, and then gave him a shot.
And then downstairs goes Farmer. Luna, to his credit, continues to push forward. Seconds to go here. Tevin Farmer tweeted out earlier today, quote, all the hard work is done. And he certainly made it look easy tonight. What a performance by Tevin Farmer as he seemingly dominates against Angel Luna. The 24-year-old out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, been training out of Rocco's gym in Blackwood, New Jersey for the last 2 years. Enter tonight with 11 consecutive victories.
You have kids, Todd. You know when they play T-ball, you put that ball up on the tee, you line it up, and then you hit it. Well, Farmer did his own version of T-ball. Watch. He holds the head right there, sets him up, but he misses the punch. But you could see what he was doing there. He's so calm and relaxed in that ring that he's able to grab the head of Luna, hold him. He's not supposed to do that. Got away with it, but missed with the punch.
Tevin Farmer looking for his 19th victory of his career. As for Friday Night Fights, less than 2 weeks from now, we are headed to Las Vegas, baby. Ishae Smith taking on Cecil McCullough. That's in our main event from the junior middleweight division, just two nights before the fight we've all been waiting for, Pacquiao versus Mayweather. We'll see you April 30th, 9 p.m. Eastern on ESPN2. Are you ready for Vegas week, Teddy? How many interviews will you be asked to do that week?
452,000. That's what I was told. Well, somewhere around that number.
You know what you should do is change your pick every radio interview you do.
No, that's not authentic. You can't do that. You've got to be consistent. You've got to stand by what you say.
So, did you just admonish me?
No, but I just said I can't do that. But I mean, you're tempted to do that.
Right. But just to keep it fresh, for goodness sakes.
I'm tempted to also say that one of the corner men in the corner of Farmer, his corner did a pretty good job tonight, had him ready, the right fight plan. One of those guys, the cut man, Lenny DeJesus from New York, long time boxing man that I know for many years.
Let's take a look at our CompuBox statistics for this, our opening bout between Angel Luna and Tevin Farmer. Power punches, Farmer 157 landed, compared to Luna's 67 jabs. Luna only landing 4 the entire fight. And there's our total punches. Farmer outlands and outthrows Angel Luna. We're still trying to figure out the scorecards here, at least get them. Not sure what the big holdup would be.
Well, you would think that'd be an easy one. You know, I mean, I have it a shutout. They don't have to agree with that, but it's got to be somewhere around that. You know, not a lot of adding on one side. It's pretty much 10 nines. Even I could add that stuff up. Should be a lot of 10 nines.
I believe our ring announcer, David Diamante, has the official scores in his hand and is ready to go. Let's ring the bell and hear what he has to say.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 8 rounds of action here at the Mohegan Sun Arena, we go to the judges' score totals, and they read as follows. Tom Carasone and Clark Sammartino, 80-72. Richard Flaherty, 79-73. All three for your winner by unanimous decision, Tevin, the American Idol Farmer.
12 straight wins for Tevin Farmer. Congratulations to him. And coming up, our co-main and main events. Division.
See, this is where Luna wants to be.
Nice uppercut there from
Inside,
Farmer.
But that's not the result he wants, because he's a sharper guy. Luna can't win if he's not inside, so I don't blame him for being there. This is the only way that he's going to win. But Farmer's better on the outside. But he's pretty good on the inside, because he makes you miss, and he makes you pay. Luna doesn't make you miss a lot.
I mentioned earlier that Farmer believes he's getting better with each and every fight. You look at his record, 18-4-1. You're not exactly blown away, but he thinks a couple more wins and he'll be in perhaps title range. Another uppercut there from Farmer, who's starting to land some of those power punches.
Again, Farmer knows what he's doing. He has a good boxing IQ. Shove there with his shoulder. And again, the young ref that I think is going to be pretty good, he jumps right in there, gives him a warning.
That's Harvey Dock. Also scheduled to referee our co-main event today. That being Danny Aquino taking on Ryan Kilczewski. Kilczewski known as the Polish Prince, 22-0.
Okay, Luna needs that jab if he's going to come forward on Farmer. Otherwise, that's going to happen. He's going to get shots thrown at him because there's nothing blocking his vision. Luna needs to block the vision of Farmer coming in.
Goodness sakes.
I'm tempted to also say that one of the corner men in the corner of Farmer, and his corner did a pretty good job tonight, had him ready, the right fight plan. One of those guys, the cut man, Lenny DeJesus from New York, long time boxing man that I know for many years.
Let's take a look at our CompuBox statistics for this, our opening bout between Angel Luna and Tevin Farmer. Power punches, Farmer 157 landed compared to Luna's 67. Jabs, Luna only landing 4 the entire fight. And there's our total punches. Farmer outlands and outthrows Angel Luna. We're still trying to figure out the scorecards here, at least get them. Not sure what the big holdup would be.
Well, you would think that'd be an easy one. You know, I mean, I have it a shutout. They don't have to agree with that, but it's got to be somewhere around that. You know, not a lot of adding on one side. It's pretty much 10 nines. Even I could add that stuff up. Should be a lot of 10 nines.
I believe our ring announcer, David Diamante, has the official scores in his hand and is ready to go. Let's ring the bell and hear what he has to say.
Ladies and gentlemen, after eight.
Tevin Farmer tweeted out earlier today, quote, all the hard work is done. And he certainly made it look easy tonight. What a performance by Tevin Farmer as he seemingly dominates against Angel Luna.
The
24-year-old out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He's been training out of Rocco's gym in Blackwood, New Jersey for the last 2 years. Entered tonight with 11 consecutive victories.
You have kids, Todd. You know when they play T-ball, you put that ball up on the tee, you line it up, and then you hit it. Well, Farmer did his own version of T-ball. Watch, he holds the head right there, sets him up, but he misses the punch. But you could see what he was doing there. He's so calm and relaxed in that ring that he's able to grab the head of Luna, hold him. He's not supposed to do that. Got away with it, but missed with the punch.
Devin Farmer looking for his 19th victory of his career. As for Friday Night Fights, less than 2 weeks from now, we are headed.
Not doing here, Luna. He's not using his jab to close the gap. And he's going to lose the fight. It's very early. He's going to lose the fight if he doesn't press behind the jab with a guy who has good eyes like Farmer. Because Farmer sees you coming, and he picks you apart. You got to throw a jab when you press.
And we are once again honored to have Nigel Collins with us here tonight. He's standing by with Bernardo Osuna.
Todd and fights that have taken place in the rich history of boxing. We're also going to talk a little bit about social media and the huge impact it had on the fight.
We send it down for round two.
Can't wait to hear more from Nigel coming up a little later on. A fast start to round two here between Farmer and Luna, Ted.
Well, again, if Luna's going to win, it's going to be with pressure getting in the chest of Farmer. Farmer's going to win, it's going to win with space and countering. And right now, this round, as you just alluded to, starts right for Luna, getting in the chest, getting close to Farmer. That's how he's going to win.
Stop.
Glove touch there. They need to wipe that glove off. And that's why I think he's a young, maybe future star referee. The referee knew that that glove touched. He made sure there's no foreign substance that could be on the glove, on the floor. He made sure he wiped it off so it doesn't get in the eye, obviously, of the opponent.
Stop.
And again, Farmer with more of a pushing blow to the side of Luna's head.
With the right hand. But other than that, it'd be Chavez chopping that tree, and trying to get a chance to yell timber around 9 or 10 rounds. It'd be Chavez, I think, winning a decision, or maybe he has a real good night, maybe a late round knockout, but a good entertaining bout.
And that's what we've got here between Farmer and Luna so far. Chavez has switched trainers, by the way, now with Joe Goosen. Freddie Roach pretty much gave up on Chavez after he gave up on himself by failing to train properly for his fight against Sergio Martinez.
He's got a little Johnny Manziel in him. Except he's accomplished things. Johnny Manziel hasn't accomplished anything.
In college, he did.
In college, yes. In college, you're right. That's very true. We're talking about the four pay ranks. Hasn't done anything in those ranks. Farmer grabbing. No surprise to see him grabbing inside. Again, he's a slickster. He knows he belongs on the outside. He can handle himself inside. He'd rather be outside with space.
Coming up tonight in our main event, undefeated Tony Superbad Harrison in action. Bernardo Osuna speaking with the unbeaten fighter.
Hey.
Successful man is a strong woman, but I guess not in the case of Tony Harrison. He doesn't have time.
And he came in his heaviest weight in almost 3 years. So a lot of advantages right now for Farmer.
At the top of the program, I mentioned a couple of big fights we're having this weekend. We'll break down Provodnikov's big battle against Lucas Matisse a little later on. But Teddy, what are your quick thoughts on the return of Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. taking on Funfara, who we've seen here on Friday Night Fights?
You get what you get with Chavez. He's a tough guy. You know, he comes with a good body shot there by Luna. He's a tough guy. He will come forward. He will go to the body. He's not the hardest guy to find. He's in front of you. He'll make entertaining fights. You wonder if he's in condition. He's had problems with partying too much. The question is he in top shape? And as far as Funfara, if Funfara can land the right hand, he's got a chance. He's got to catch Chavez coming in with the right hand. He punches pretty good with the right hand. But other than that, it'll be Chavez chopping that tree, and trying to get a chance to yell timber around 9 or 10 rounds. it'd be Chavez, I think, winning a decision. Or maybe he has a real good night. Maybe a late-round knockout, but a good, entertaining bout.
And that's what we've got here between Farmer and Luna so far. Chavez has switched trainers, by the way, now with Joe Goosen. Freddie Roach pretty much gave up on Chavez after he gave up on himself by failing. And when you're watching at home, Teddy, I'm sure you're a fan. Maybe you don't know too much about these guys. You want to find a reason either to root for them or against them. Farmer says he wants to be a role model for all the kids in Philadelphia and all over the world, loves to give back. As for Luna, when he's not in the boxing gym, he likes to go to church. So who do you pull against in this fight?
Neither one. You pull for both of them. They're two fine, I mean fine, young men. And decent fighters, too. And again, the more refined fighter so far, and no surprise to me, because it really sits with the scouting reports I got on him. Farmer, the more refined guy, more developed.
Farmer played football and basketball in high school, and then one time he said he had a lull, didn't really have either sport to focus on. They were both out of season, so he went to the gym, trained in boxing just to stay in shape, fell in love, and never went back to the other sports.
You know, Luna's just throwing punches, but Farmer is placing punches. Big difference.
See on his trunks, Farmer, American Idol. That was a moniker given to him by some of his friends in Philadelphia because he is such a good role model to some of the disadvantaged youth there in Philadelphia. And he looks pretty darn good tonight as we approach the end of round two.
Punches from way back. And he again, Luna doesn't press behind that jab. A lot of incoming coming at him. Farmer is so slick. He doesn't mind if he's inside, outside, even though he belongs outside. And he's a bigger guy, too. I mean, he's bigger. He's been between junior lightweight and lightweight most of his career, Todd. While Luna has only been a featherweight most of his career, only 125 pounds his last two fights, Mr. Luna.
Luna in the face looks a lot like Yuri Gamboa. Of course, the Cuban boxer, who most recently lost to Terrence Crawford, at least most notably. Right now, Elgato trying to figure out Farmer, hasn't been able to seemingly do so, as Farmer has been very effective with the jab and with counter shots.
Farmer has, you know, those bloodlines to Joe Gans. Maybe they're showing a little bit, but he's got a good instinct in that ring. I don't want to say he's a natural, but he's pretty good for a guy who only had 16 amateur fights, I'll tell you that. And he's fighting a guy in Luna who had a lot more. He had about 70 amateur fights.
Maybe that's why Farmer got off to such a slow start. 4-4-1, and then went on an 11-fight win streak. 1-1.
Yes, thank you.
Good team. Teamwork.
That was good. That was a beach ball.
You could say, though, Farmer is head and shoulders better than Luna.
Well, you could just stop now. Oh, go ahead. And I think that'll would appreciate
that. Do her.
And I'm sure the people in the truck would appreciate that, too.
Let him go. Stop holding.
Again, no jab from Luna. Good vision, good eyes by Farmer. He can do his work.
Desperation time for Elgato. Can Angel Luna come up with something big in round eight? Whoa.
Time!
Working your way up the ladder. That's exactly what Mr. Farmer's doing. Some downstairs and eventually two upstairs. Gets the job done. Setting it up nicely.
Catch him up.
If you're Luna's corner, what do you tell him right now as he has 3 minutes to figure something out?
Chuck a lot of right hands. Right hands land sometimes with a southpaw. Basically, get lucky. Best punch to get lucky with against the lefty would be a right. See, I would have told him really from the beginning, give a little feint before you throw. Don't throw cold punches with a guy that has radar. You know, throw him off. Throw his radar off a little bit. Feint a little bit, and then chuck something. Get him to.